Okay, now that we know how to write our answers for inequalities when we solve them, let's actually do some solving of linear inequalities or inequalities in general. And I categorize the types we are going to talk about here. So first thing I have on my list is simple linear. Okay, so let's put the title here, simple linear inequalities. So let's explain the title, all right? Why do we call it? Well, first of all, we call this an inequality because what do you see? So on your test, you will know you're doing an inequality and not an equation because what do you see?
Equals.
Not the equals, but what?
Equal to.
No, inequality. Right, you see the less than, right? Okay, equations, you see equal sign everywhere because Christian, that might be absent. And you still have an inequality, right? Okay, so it's the less than really that makes it an inequality. All right. So we explained the word inequality, that's what you know. You're doing an inequality. What else should we explain? Linear, we did this yesterday in class, right, for equations, right? This is an inequality, this is a linear inequality. How will you know in your test that you're dealing with a linear inequality and not a non-linear inequality? What do you see here or not see?
No.
The degree is one. The degree is 1, 1, 1. No fractions. This guy is not sitting under, right? Okay? No degree 2. What else? No radicals. I don't think we'll do radical inequalities, okay? Although we can. All right, so linear degree is 1, degree is 1. Why is it simple? And later on, we're going to talk about compound. What is the difference between simple and compound? You forgot it? We did it in class. Simple versus compound. Actually, when we were doing the notations,
Only one.
Yeah, look at those answers. These answers over here that we were doing earlier, you see how many inequality symbols?
Two.
These actually will be answers to compound inequalities. That's why you see two inequality symbols, right? But this is simple because you see only one inequality symbol. All right? So you look at this problem, you know you're dealing with an inequality, and actually you say, well, I think I can do that, right? Can you?
Yes.
Who wants to show it?
Open press.
All you do is like what we were doing yesterday with equations. Anybody want to take over from here and show us how to do it?
Open parenthesis.
You don't want anyone? Yeah. And try to explain as you go along, okay? No, just be careful. So what will you do first? Distribute. You are distributing a negative 4, okay, so you have minus 8,
and you copy it.
So it's like before, right? Okay, okay, you're done. Now she might get a heart attack if I force her to stay here. Okay, so she distributed was the first step, okay? I was just thinking that this morning I said all my problems, I think I have a minus sign, okay? You might forget that if that's a plus sign, do you have to worry about changing signs? Esma? No, right? No. So it's 4x plus 8. So you have this. It's the same as yesterday. So all we do is what? What do we do with this side? You combine like terms first, right?
Yes.
So, Svetlana, you want to show, to tell me or show me?
First we put the other one. We put 2x.
No, you can actually combine terms.
Okay, 3x minus 4x minus x.
Just to be consistent with what we did yesterday.
Minus x minus 3 minus 8 give us minus 11. Less than greater than 2x.
Less than or equal to 2x.
Less than or equal.
2x plus 4.
Plus 4.
Good, okay.
Then put 2x on the left.
Mm-hmm.
Minus x. Minus 2x and minus 11 put on the right.
So it would be plus 11, okay?
Minus x minus 2x minus 3x less than equal than 15. Then x divided by minus 3.
Mm-hmm.
X less than
Okay.
And graph.
Almost good. No, before you graph, I have to catch you first. Okay.
Oh, we need to change sign.
Why? Why do we need to change the symbol?
We divided negative.
When you divide or multiply by a negative number, we said we have to switch, right?
Switch.
Or reverse the inequality. Is that clear? So the less than or greater has to be greater. Less than or equal has to be greater than or equal. Is that clear? Mm-hmm. Now you have my blessing to graph it.
Here is minus 5 greater or equal.
Means you go to the right.
Right.
Okay.
And we need to include minus 5
mm-hmm.
because we have
the equal sign.
Yes.
And the interval notation is what?
Interval notation will be brackets minus 5 and
infinity.
Infinity
is really just like an 8 lying down, just in case. Right? Okay, so you have that. Thank you, Svetlana. And I know on your test, I told you not to bother with set notation, okay? So I think it's a big thing already to come up with these answers. Any questions on this? Okay, so let's try another one. So very important, and you switch it only when you divide or multiply by negative. Otherwise, again, you're safe. You're okay to do whatever you want. Okay, let me just show you another way. Svetlana, from here to here, what she did was to move the 2x or transpose the 2x to the left. She got a minus 2x there. Move the constant negative 11 to the right. She got plus 11. I was explaining that really what she did was to subtract 2x from both sides, right? And to add 11 to both sides. And usually that's the strategy for linear stuff, right? Linear equations, linear inequalities. You want all your variables on one side, all your numbers on the other side. Now, another way of doing this, if you guys want to avoid your negative coefficients, okay? Yes, so let's see, you're here. You can also, of course, what? Get rid of the minus x on the left, okay? So you can add x to both sides. Let's do it slowly. So then you'll get negative 11 on this side, right? Less than or equal to 3x plus 4 on the other side, okay, then you don't have any negative number there. And then your goal is to isolate x, so therefore you have to kick out the plus 4 by what?
Negative.
Subtracting 4. So then you will get negative 15 on this side, on the left, on the right you'll have 3x. And now, of course, you want x alone and it's a time, so to counter the times you have to divide, right? By 3, and notice I just do it recklessly, I don't have to worry because I'm dividing by
positive
3. So therefore I have negative 5 less than or equal to 3, to x rather, okay? And this is the answer, which we said is really the same as what Svetlana got, right? Which was x greater than or equal to negative 5, okay? So either way you do it, you can move everybody to the left or one to the right, okay, and it will work out. Okay, next thing we talk about are compound linear inequalities. Again, let's try to analyze if we can, if we see this again somewhere in our lives, okay, how we know. Inequalities, because what? You have inequality symbol, right? Okay. Linear, again, why is this just a linear inequality? Because just
degree one,
no fractions, no denominator. Well, there is a fraction, right? But there's no variable under, okay? So these are just polynomial. This is a polynomial expression, degree one. Compound because we see what?
And.
All right? So after you know what to do with that, you just have to look at each one, right? Okay? And I guess you guys can just rattle off the steps here. What do we do here? Esma, what do I do?
Add 4.
Yeah, add 4 to both sides, right? So we get what? 3x less than
3,
and then?
Divide by 3.
Just like before, right? Okay, so you'll have x less than 1 is one part of the answer, right? Over on this side, what did we do when we saw fractions? I know Christian had a term for that.
We killed the fraction.
Okay, Christian, how did we kill the fraction? How did we get rid of the fraction?
Multiply.
Can
multiply
we?
Multiply everybody by?
Two.
Two. Oops. I should. So you multiply this by two, multiply this by two, and you guys understand why I'm doing it three times, right? Okay? Mm-hmm. Two on the left, two on the right. I don't need to worry about switching my inequality symbol because two is what kind of a number?
Positive.
It's a positive number, right? So I just have to watch out for those things. Okay. Distribute the two on the left. That's why you see it twice. Cancel. So now we have what?
One.
X
plus one.
Plus two times one is?
Two.
Two greater than?
Negative four.
Negative four, right? And then the next step is what?
Subtract two.
Subtract two from both sides. So therefore you get X is?
Negative
six. Greater than negative six, okay? And let's go back to the connective here. It's the word and, right? Okay? So x less than 1 and x greater than negative 6. Does anybody want to show how to find these guys on the number line?
Yes.
X less than 1, x greater than negative 6. Christian wants to do it. Okay.
Could you label them, please?
Yes. -6. And then, so you see, x is greater than negative 6. So that would be everything over here. And then, x is less than 1. So then that would be everything going this way. And then we see that there is no little equal.
Okay.
Line, if you will, on the bottom. So we have parentheses for both of them. And that means that we will shade inside of or between negative 6 and 1, and you have parentheses. So the answer would look like negative 6, 1.
That's the interval notation, right?
Interval.
And the graph, of course, you showed right there, okay?
Yes.
Again, that's the story because you want both of them to happen. So and means you want both to happen at the same time. So Christian did a good job explaining that, right? Okay, thanks, Christian.
Actually, before going on to the next problem, Esmat has a question. How do we write this? These are the two things I require from my students on your test, okay, on Tuesday. The graph and the interval notation. Of course, if you'd like to write this in set notation, I guess... I said you just put the braces, right? And either you copy this, or actually for this case, what is a better way of writing this? We saw that earlier. What is it?
First you put X in the middle.
Put X in the middle, and then what? It's in between?
1 and 6.
Negative 6 on the left and 1 on the right. Do I care for any of these numbers? No, right? Okay. So yeah, I really love the graph because yeah. Shows me how to write all my other answers, okay? Times the quantity y plus 1 less than y minus 4. I hope I copied my problem correctly there, okay? So, again, this is a compound inequality because you see the word or. This is linear because this is a polynomial degree
1,
right? Okay? You can, of course, later on have compound quadratic inequalities, but, you know, we can all mess this up, okay? Greater than, greater, less than, so these are inequalities. And so what is the thing to do?
Distribute.
So anybody want to work? Two of you can work on, but there are really two separate inequalities you can work on, right? Okay? So who wants to do the left? Okay, you want to do the left, Svetlana, and you want to do the right, Christian?
Sure.
Okay, I'll record you guys.
Graph.
It's okay, you can graph yours.
this?
Actually, we have to collaborate after this, right? Because we are... Okay, thank you. You want to stay there or you want... Okay, so these are both simple, right? Inequalities. So Svetlana distributed the negative sign. So she got 2y minus y minus 3 plus 3 greater than negative 3. She ended up with y greater than negative 6. Is that clear, right? So the 3 on the left gets moved to the right. That becomes a minus 3. Minus 3 minus 3 is negative 6. And then for Christian, you distributed a 2. So you got 2y plus 2 less than y minus 4. Then you get y less than negative 6. So they both graphed the solutions that they got for their inequalities. Now let's figure out what we want to do with or. So right now, one of you should draw a number line to put these answers together. And notice that how many numbers did we get in this particular problem? Just one, right? In class, we were getting like weird things. Okay, Christian, you need a straight edge. Okay,
yeah.
So which number do you put on that number line?
Negative 6.
Negative 6, okay. All right. So Christian, you got which part?
Less than.
The one going on to the left. So could you draw that again on this one? Thank you. And you said you don't like negative 6, right? All right. Svetlana, do you want to go over there and draw your answer? Graph your answer. Okay, so Svetlana is going from negative 6 to the right and not including negative 6. Okay, let's think. Our word is or. That's the connective for these two inequalities. So we said we want either, actually we have red and black, right? Either the red or the black graph. Okay, what does that mean, Svetlana?
All real numbers.
Do we want all of them?
Yes.
Almost right. You want all real numbers? Look at the graph.
No
minus 6. Okay, very good. So how do you write that? I don't think I've shown you that.
R.
How would you write this in interval notation? Interval notation. The usual. Go down there. Go down there. No, interval notation with parentheses and brackets and blah, blah, blah. Christian, write your answer at the bottom.
Sorry.
Yeah, you're right, Svetlana. So the left number for your answer is?
For my answer.
Minus what?
Infinity.
What's the right number?
Plus infinity.
No, on your answer, just the red, yeah, minus 6, right? Christian, could you write yours as the same line as Svetlana's? Sorry, I'm a dictator here. Okay, write it down. Okay.
You switch. I write your answer.
Yeah.
His is the red. Okay, that's why he wasn't very happy. Okay. It's okay.
Sad.
You're not sad. Okay. So those are the two answers you got in interval notation. And then we said, what did we want to do with these two answers?
Combine.
We want to combine them, unite them. What's this? Unite. So you want to get the union, right? So you get the union. So that's one way of writing your answer. Or as Svetlana said, well, it looks like I'm grabbing all of the number line except
minus six,
right? So therefore, what you can say also is you can just write it in words. All real numbers except negative 6, okay? Mm-hmm. Or do you want me to show you how to write it nicely?
Just R.
R. Write it over there, the R, the double R. Svetlana, you can do the honors, okay? Write the R with the double thing there. Put a minus, a slash, a backslash.
Here?
You know how to write a backslash?
No.
I know, I didn't. Oh, that's too big.
That's too big.
R, backslash.
That's actually this way.
Oh, let me do it, guys. Come over, okay.
One way of doing it, or if you want, you can write your answer as just to say, well, I want all the real numbers except, you can do this in math, okay? This is your backslash negative 6. Put negative 6 in set notation. Okay, I don't know if you want to remember that. Or
can
on the test,
you can
just
circle and cross.
No, just this, okay? All real numbers except the number negative 6, okay? Well, normally in class, what we were getting were intervals that were like far apart, right? Okay, so that's why you were kind of used to them being apart, and we just did this, okay? Since we're on the subject of this, I don't know, I don't want to solve another inequality like this. Sometimes you could have a problem like, let's say you get something like y greater than negative 6, or let's say you have y less than 5. Remember this? Okay? So you have y greater than negative 6. So here we have two numbers, right? Okay? Negative 6 is here, 5 is here. Y greater than negative 6 means what?
Right.
From negative 6 should go right. All the way. We don't care for negative 6, right? Okay? Y less than 5 means what?
To the left.
From 5, I go to the left. I don't care for 5 in this case. Okay? Well, I can put an equal sign if you wish, okay? Just to, for variety's sake. Okay? Now again, the word I'm looking at is or. So I want either this or this to happen, right? And what did we say in class when we have this kind of scenario? So we want this as well as this, okay? Or this to happen. So in this case, what's our answer? We end up shading which?
Between negative 6 and 5.
Are you sure? Or. It's not and.
This left side.
I want either this or this.
Negative.
So I want this to happen or this to happen. I'm fine. So I'm fine really with what?
Negative infinity.
I'm fine with anything. Correct?
Yes.
Okay? I'm fine if this happens. I'm also fine if this happens. So I'm fine. No matter what.
Oh, really?
Right? So therefore, in this case, so just like what you said there over there, I'm fine with either to the left of negative 6 or to the right of negative 6. Mm-hmm. It just so happens here that there was an overlap, right? Okay? So I'm fine with this or this, so therefore I'm fine with negative infinity to
positive,
positive
except
infinity.
Minus,
or you can write it as a, as r, right?
Except minus 6.
Why would you say except?
Because we don't
include. You're fine with this happening or with this happening. But negative 6 is here, so you're fine with it being less than or equal to 5. Mm-hmm. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
Okay? You're saying, I'm happy with this, I'm also happy with this. Therefore, I'm happy with either one of them, so I can take everybody. Right?
Yes.
Over here, you're saying, I'm happy if you give me numbers to the left of negative 6. I'm also happy if you give me numbers to the right of negative 6, right?
Yes.
So I'm happy with both. Give me both. Okay. The story changes if I change the connective to what? Let's make the
and.
If I change the or to an and for this one. You following? Right? Now it's and. Again, and is harder, right? So now I'm very hard to please, okay? I'll only be happy if you give me this and this. You understand? All right?
Yes.
You understand? Earlier it was easier. I said, oh, it's fine. Do me this or this, okay? So here we're saying, I want this to happen and this to happen, okay? What will you tell me? I want x to be to the left of negative 6, and I want x to be to the right of negative 6. What would you say? Over here you say, I want y to be bigger than or equal to negative 6, and less than or equal to 5. Which one is easier to answer for you?
Probably the right one.
The right one, we saw this earlier, right? We said and, the story of and is you want both to happen at the same time, right, Christian?
Mm-hmm.
So the right one for you, I think, is easier to answer because you said, well, you want this to happen and at the same time that to happen. So therefore, where is it happening at the same time?
In there.
In the middle, right? So the answer to and is what?
Negative.
In between negative 6 and 5, right? Okay. Do I want negative 6, Vitlana?
No.
Now you sure, you see what? Why? Okay? Because you want this to be happy as well, right? So you don't want negative 6, now do you want 5?
Yes.
Yes. Okay? You see the difference?
Yes.
Okay? Let's go back to the original problem number 7 that I revised by changing the connective to and, right? Now, I'm really, really hard to please, right? So I said, okay, the only way for me to be happy is if x is to the left of negative 6 and x is to the right of negative 6. What will you tell me? What will you say? Is it possible for me to be happy if
no.
I want that kind of situation?
And
I want the x to be smaller than negative 6, and at the same time I want the x to be bigger than negative 6.
There's no solution.
There's no way you can make me happy, right? Okay? There's no solution to my problem. Alright, so therefore, the answer for this, if you were to do an and, is the empty set, or you can write it like this, or you can simply say in words, no solution. Did you understand the and and the or?
Yes.
Okay. So think of it in terms of real life. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
What makes you happy? I'm okay with either one. You have a bigger, you're happier more, right? If you're okay with whatever, right? We can either do this or that. But the more constraints you put, the more unhappy you become, right? Because it's like you have to satisfy a lot of stuff. I can only be happy if this and this and this. Get it? Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Math is life. All right, okay.